Hi, my name is Joe Ferdet. I'm a Senior Business Development Manager with Waters in the Biopharmaceutical Business Unit. With me today is Dr. Sean McCarthy, a Senior Manager on our science team, and we're going to discuss the use of the ACQUITY QDa Mass Detector for glycan monitoring. So Sean, I wonder if you could start off by talking a little bit about the analytical trends in glycan monitoring and why biopharma labs desire mass data in glycan monitoring.
Well, some of the current trends in glycan analysis that we've seen is a migration from what I would call traditional capillary electrophoresis methods, maybe to more LC types of analyses, which would rely on helix separations. And in addition, there seems to be an increased need or requirement for people to collect orthogonal mass data as part of the characterization of the glycans within their molecules. And a large move towards understanding and getting mass information is that the glycans themselves are often attributed and considered critical quality parameters within or aspects of the molecule. And because of that, there needs to be a really clear understanding of what structures are on the molecule, and in addition to monitor those structures to ensure that throughout the production process that those structures do not change.
Remains consistent, yeah.
Exactly. So remaining consistent is really a key, because glycan structures themselves are impart a lot of the safety and efficacy aspects of the molecule.
So glycan monitoring has been done previously through fluorescence detection alone. What information does mass detection provide that fluorescence detection can't provide?
Well, one of the challenges with using only fluorescence detection for glycan analysis is that each of the molecules that are in that analysis, the glycan structures are generally labeled with a fluorophore. And each of the signals that you receive or collect from that analysis, they're virtually identical, as the structure of the modification, the label, is the same for every structure. So by incorporating mass data, that allows you to discriminate more accurately between the different structures within a separation. And it gives you a greater degree of specificity in a particular structure. So where in the past people may have used glucose units alone, or maybe relative retention times of the glycan structures, adding mass data gives the added assurance that the structure that you've assigned is correct.
So it actually confirms the structure via mass confirmation?
Exactly.
Do you have any specific examples of challenges that customers are facing today that can be addressed by the addition of a mass detector?
Yeah, some of the challenges that we've been discussing with our customers really center around method transfer, so transferring a method from one laboratory to another. In some cases, the selectivity of a separation may change slightly, so the ability to use mass data allows them to then track the components across each of those separations. And in addition, one particular example would be in terms of method development. Trying to separate a particular critical pair for a separation, two different glycan structures, for example, mannose-5 and maybe a G2F structure, and ensuring that you don't end up in any coelutions as part of your method development and ongoing development process.
I understand that traditional labeling techniques have had pretty poor MS sensitivity. So how is it that the QDa can be applied to these opportunities?
Recently, we've introduced the GlycoWorks Rapiflor MS labeling reagent, which has been designed in such a way that it offers many aspects that are useful for glycan analysis, and one of them being the improved MS sensitivity. So the reagent has been designed in such a way that we can do rapid labeling of released N-glycans, taking what has historically been a day and a half labeling procedure and converting that into a 30-minute labeling procedure from glycoprotein to released and labeled glycans ready for analysis.
Wow, that's pretty significant.
And then the other improvements that we've designed into the Rapiflor MS have been significant improvements in the fluorescence signal. We've seen roughly 14x improvement in fluorescence. And probably most importantly is the improvement in the MS sensitivity, where we're seeing about a 1,000-fold improvement from MS signal compared to conventional labeling reagents.
Wow.
So if we take those two aspects along with the rapid labeling of the glycans themselves, that's really what's enabling people to use the ACQUITY QDa. Historically, the use of something like the QDa would not have been possible for the reasons that you had stated earlier.
That sounds great, Sean. So really super fast sample prep and the combination of fluorescence and mass detection sounds like a really powerful combination. Are there other ways that customers can leverage these technologies?
Well, some of the opportunities that we've been discussing with our customers are particularly in the area of bioreactor monitoring and the process development of the bioreactor. And what we've been discussing with them is the enabling technology with RapiFluorMS in terms of rapid N-glycan sample preparation, the labeling with RapiFluorMS, and then combining that with the ACQUITY QDa offers them an opportunity to monitor their bioprocess. So in those discussions, we've been discussing not only the rapid sample preparation, which as we discussed, can be completed within 30 minutes, but also taking the chromatographic method and scaling that method down to roughly 10 minutes. So, which means that within about a 40-minute window, our customers are realizing a benefit of seeing the bioreactor and that process from the glycan level, which is important for them as the glycan profile of the therapeutic is critical to the product quality at the end. So being able to quickly monitor that and monitor on a regular basis is really important.
So I get the shorter sample prep, but how is it that the ACQUITY QDa enables a shorter chromatographic method?
So part of that comes down to the ability to collect selected ion chromatograms or selected ion recording. So you can look at the mass specifically of one particular glycan or maybe several glycans and look at how they're changing differentially within the same process. So the addition of mass information gives you the ability to target just those species that are of interest in your process.
And so I guess you don't need as much chromatographic resolution because you have the mass data?
Exactly.
So Sean, I understand that glycan structures are pretty diverse. They range from simple basic forms to highly complex multi-antennary forms. Can the QDa detector detect all of these?
Yeah, something we've investigated is looking at the range of structures that we can apply to with the QDa to look at. So some of the work that we've done, we've looked at released N-glycan analysis from IgG, which are really simple biantennary structures, RNase B, which really represents the pool of high mannose structures, and perhaps the most complicated structures we've looked at are some of those that come from bovine fetulin, which are very highly branched, highly silated structures. What we found in each of those analyses was a very, very good correlation between the fluorescence data that we would collect and the data we collect from the QDa. So essentially all of the structures that we would see in the fluorescence trace, there was corresponding mass data from the QDa that allowed us to confirm what particular structure were in each of the chromatographic peaks. And I think that was something that made us realize that this is really enabling across a wide range of different glycan structures that our customers are looking at as they both develop IgG type of therapeutics and then move on to maybe more complex types of biomolecules as well.
Thank you very much, Sean.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. If you would like to learn more about either the RapiFluorMS labeling reagent or the QDa for glycan monitoring, visit waters.com/biopharmqda. And thank you very much.